అందరికి సంతోషంగా ఉందా?
ఆర్ యు ఆల్ హ్యాపీ?
బి ఆల్వేస్ హ్యాపీ, హ్యాపీ, హ్యాపీ.
From Qatar are here to remind ourselves about our good old days we had in Qatar. Let us give a good amount of gratitude to our dear Swami for arranging this, and he has made one or two among us as the instruments. One is Brother Maravi and Brother Ahmad. We owe our gratitude to both of you. Today is more special because of three reasons. One is we have been in full bliss after Swami's 87th birthday. Second thing is one of Swami's closest devotees, Professor Anil Kumar, we are here to celebrate his birthday too, which has been on 25th of August, or October. And third, for me, Anil, it is one of the wonderful days that one of our children's birthday, that is Siddharth. He is a child in my prayers, daily prayers. I'm really thankful to Swami that I'm here on this particular day. So I had to come all the way from Qatar. I'm not talking much. Let me ask Brother Maroli to do the speech.
With our
friends
at the Lotus Feet, the Lord Sri Sai Baba, respected Sri Anil Kumar ji, brothers and sisters, Sai Ram, particularly my dearest friends from Doha, that are those who are in and those who have left the great city like me. I don't know whether I am qualified to talk in front of Professor Anil Kumar. Nevertheless, I was asked to do a job and I will try to do it. Who doesn't know Professor Anil Kumar? I don't think anybody will raise the hand. Nevertheless, I wish to say Professor Anil Kumar is hailing from Guntur, Andhra Pradesh. Sri Anil Kumar is in Swami's school, serving Swami since 1972. For the past 22 years, Sri Anil Kumar was blessed by translating Swami's speech. Sir, please correct me if I'm going wrong. Written about 27 books, widely traveled around the world, visited about 30 countries, spreading Swami's message. We had the privilege of meeting Sri Anil Kumar in close proximity when we visited our daughter, Poonam, in Dallas, USA, a couple of times. And for our good fortune, Professor Anil Kumar was also visiting his daughter in Dallas then. And Sri Anil Kumar served as principal at Vrindavan campus and as professor of bioscience in Tirupati. Sir, inadvertently, if I omitted any landmark, please let me know. Kindly excuse me. And finally, I wish to express our gratitude on behalf of all the devotees assembled here to Mr. Satish Nayak and Sri Kamath. Thank you, gentlemen, for creating this occasion where we can interact with the professor. Devotees from Mangalore had the great opportunity of interacting and listening to wonderful experience of Sri Satyajit with our Bhagwan very recently, and we will be blessed once again, hopefully, with the presence of Professor Anil Kumar in Mangalore on January 6th.
Oh, you have come to know already.
Yes. And we look forward once again for your presence, sir. Thank you, Jisa.
Good. In good spirits. Good. Good, good, good. I'm so happy to be amongst you this morning. I express my deep sense of gratitude to Sri Kamat and his wife for extending invitation to us to be here and also give us the pleasure to congratulate and convey our best wishes with many happy returns of the day to Siddharth, who is celebrating his birthday today. Siddharth, the very name says, is the very embodiment of silence. The silence is more than eloquence, as Baba says. It is only in silence that the voice of God is heard. I personally feel that Siddharth is a saint among us. And it is an opportunity given to us to come to know him and serve him in whatever way we can. I thank Kamat and his wife who could be so close to us within the shortest time possible. It shows their cheerfulness, their devotion, their faith, their commitment as to come so near and dear to all of us here in Sai family. We welcome them wholeheartedly into Sai family here in Prasanthalayam with assurance and reassurance any number of times that we are with him, not behind or ahead of him, that we are with him for whatever he wants. He is quite free to let us know so that we have best of the periods in Prasanthalayam. Best of the time. He should say that he is very happy here more than in Qatar or Doha or whatever. He is a widely traveled man. I eagerly look forward to a day when he says, Anil Kumar, I am very happy here. Till then, I will be eagerly waiting to serve him, make him happy in every way. To give you a simple example, mother-in-law of my daughter, my own daughter, she is from Madras. For some reasons, she had to quit Madras. And she is close to 80, with a pelvic fracture and other problems, health problems. But slowly she is recovering. And she is to be rehabilitated. Where? That was the question to my daughter and son-in-law. The only language known to some of the people is only to shed tears. As parents, we can't see children cry like that. I would prefer to cry on their behalf rather than see them cry. So I said, please send her, we'll take care of her. And then she is here. And I was thinking of a place where she could stay. I had chosen a place where, surrounded by all devotees whom I know for the last 40 years. And they peep into the room morning and evening to say, how are you? And she is quite happy. And I said, Amma, I am waiting for a day when you refuse to go back to Madras, when you refuse to go to your daughters and son, so that they will come here, they will have your darshan and Swami darshan too. Then only my efforts are successful, and then only I feel good. Till then, I'll see how you are and all that. She has been very comfortable. And our friend Kamak and his wife are relatively young when compared to her. She is in her 80s. they are relatively young, and the reports I got, just one or two, say that they are very enthusiastic and very active in Sai service and activity. And I tasted little bit, because he has taken us to Anantapur and to Chennai. We have seen the taste of the spirit of service of Brother Kamath. So I pray Baba's choicest blessings on the couple, and more so on the son, on this happy occasion of his birthday. May Bhagwan be with you forever and ever, and grant you long life, healthy life, spiritual life of service and devotion. Thank you once again. There is nothing that Swami cannot do. When Anil Kumar, hailing from town, a town like Guntur in Andhra Pradesh, having had the education up to college level in Telugu medium, made by Swami as the divine translator to translate his talks into English for 23 long years, speaks of the power of Sai more than the capacity of Anil Kumar. It speaks of the divinity of Sai more than my ability. His divinity excels our ability. His power is more than our capacity. I am the living proof to that. I always consider that I am just made by Baba to this level and standard. And I also remember my past and recall every moment to glorify Baba. Swami, you made me this. Swami, you brought me to this stature. It's all your goodness. Or else I know what I was and what I am today. And another thing is also this, things spiritually cannot be counted in terms of currency and bank account. Material things can be measured, material things can be estimated in terms of the acquisition of property and income tax balance sheet. So it is not furniture, it is not plots and houses or bank account that could be taken as criteria for spiritual progress or advancement. And moreover, the spiritual journey is a tough journey, very tough journey, because gold is so nice to wear, but it's a challenge to walk on the street with gold. The life has to be insured. There may be gunman by your side. Gold is so nice to wear, good, but safety, double problem. Similarly, spirituality is gold, but maintenance of it is a challenge. Why? First point, my friends, spirituality is a life of challenges. Why? There will be many dissuading forces. There will be many blocks. There will be many obstacles. There will be many, many discouraging factors, the near and dear. My mother, brother, sister, parents-in-law, my friends and colleagues considered me as a fool number one to have left my native place and decided to settle here in response to the call of Bhagwan Baba. When I decided to come here, all of them considered me a fool. I'm not irritated by that. Why? Mother is 70, above 70, close to 80. She needs tender care. Family can feel bad because I have three daughters and a son. Still they are studying. Second year medicine, third year medicine, boy is studying engineering. So they have reason. And in-laws also don't like it because they are lucky enough to have the rest of the children settled in America. And my wife is the only piece available in India to take care of them. So I can understand. No one is in favor of it. And my friends thought that I lost my brains. I told them I never had any brain to lose it. I'm a brainless man. Brainless man. Because I didn't think twice when Swami asked me to come. Brain should think. We are gifted with brain to think. But I have no brain. He just asked me to come, therefore I came, that's all. Without informing anybody. Without sanction or approval of my family. Why friends are against this proposal? I was earning a lot of money as a teacher. It is a good standard of earnings in those days. I was giving lectures to medical students, medical entrance students, for which we were heavily paid for spread over a 2 months' time. It is highly competitive thing, highly competitive. With Baba, ready for competition, ready for competence, ready for comparison, ready. Because with Baba, we are heroes. Without him, we are zeros. He will never let down us. That's my experience, my friends. He will see you always on the top. Always. We never lag behind. But the world has got its own calculations. World has got its own estimates. From their point of view, we may be a failure. The friends thought that I left all my lucrative earnings and all that, simply resigned and came here. So they have got their own reason. But the only reason for my settlement here is, God who gives, asked me to come over here personally. It is something like Lord Vamana asking Emperor Bali, give me 3 feet of land. And guru preceptor of Emperor Bali, Shukracharya, told Bali, don't do that. The fellow who came here is not ordinary fellow, Vamana. He'll finish you. Don't give that. He's not ordinary man. Spiritual dynamite. He'll finish you up. Don't give. Then Vamana says, look here, Guruji. The one who came is Lord himself, as you said. I have nothing to say no. But yet, Master, please understand. The Lord who gives and gives and gives has stretched his hand in front of me to give him 3 feet of land. Stretched his hand asking me, what more I want in this world? That's what Vamana said. So similarly, when Baba asked me to come here, well, I thought there is nothing more in this world than to do what he said. And that is the biggest challenge to begin with. Later, many challenges in life, many challenges. Life is not that green as we want it to be. Life is not bed of roses. Life is not a dreamland. Life is not mere expectations. Life is more a ground reality. The ground reality many times is contradictory to our hopes, dreams and expectations. With the result in this conflict, many, many, many people are lost with the passage of time. They decide to quit. Many people left like that. Because the challenges are unexpected. But yet, that is the way that you have chosen. But somehow, the one who makes you withstand all these challenges and tests of time is none else other than God Himself. So the second reason, I wholly, with gratitude, thank Swami for having given me this courage to face all these challenges in this life sojourn, particularly along the spiritual line. First, for calling me here. Secondly, you have given me the strength to bear all this. And thirdly, there is bright side of life, bright side of life. We cannot ignore the bright side of life. What is that bright side of life? I have learnt over a period of time what spirituality is, why spirituality is, where does it take me? Is this all be all and end all, or is there anything further? Is it the only family that matters until I breathe my last breath? Is it only the children and the family that matter till my last breath? Or is there anything more? How about the scriptures that I read? How about the discourses I heard? When to start implementing them? When to start practicing them? Have I made a beginning? How far am I? What is the target? What is the goal? Am I closer to the goal or away from the goal? Would never be around the goal. Something like checklist of income tax. I got these questions in front of me, daily answering, but yet I have not got a satisfactory answer. Still, spirituality is a long journey. In the rest of the life, I do not know the number of years left for me. I have decided, come what may, having traveled this far, I am not prepared to give up. I have decided to spread His message more intensively than before. Yes. More intensively. I have determined to clear the doubts of so many devotees whose doubts are not cleared and answered by anybody they know. I am ready to answer them. I am prepared to answer them. With honesty, with truth, as to say, I do not know when I do not know. Meaning, I do not bluff. I do not imagine. No. I simply say, I don't know if I don't know. So to clear the doubts, that's my second objective in my continued stay here. And the third one is, we are family people. We have got our own problems. And we want somebody to come to our help. Somebody to come to our rescue. We are family people. Swami, my son should get visa. Swami, my daughter should get married without dowry. My son should get married with a lot of dowry. But two contradictory God, poor God has to oblige me. One to see no dowry, other dowry. So he has got his own problems. So we have, Swami, I have got the joint pains today. Tomorrow I have headache. So long there is body, there will be some problems. Some problem here and there. As we age, problems will be with us. We have to learn to live comfortably with the problems. Oh, joint pains, I am happy with you. I always joke with my friends. In my younger days, I was a romantic. And today I am rheumatic. That's it. Well, I enjoy both. Why not? Why not? To know those, the value of those sweet days, I should have this romanticism. But I have no regrets because I had the bright side of life then. Therefore, my friends, we are quite happy along the spiritual field, the challenges of life. And the next challenge would be, to see that we do not lose our faith in Bhagavan because of media, because of rumors, because of gossip, because of baseless, useless allegations and charges. Simple example. If anyone comes to me and says, Mr. Anil Kumar, your father is a drunkard, am I going to accept it? No. My father takes only coffee. I know that. He's not a drunkard. Even the whole world says that my father is a drunkard. If the whole TV channels, newspapers say that he is a drunkard, I am not prepared to believe, because he is my father. I am closest to him than any media or any press for that matter. He is not Baba our father. He is not Baba our father. Are you not going to have equal trust in him? Are you going to be carried away by somebody else? Well, that is the question I have. If anybody says my mother is dishonest, am I going to accept it? Because my mother is known for honesty all over the state of Andhra Pradesh, because she was a retired gazetted government officer, very honest, highly qualified, MA literature gold medal. Such a lady of a beautiful personality, integrity, individuality, responsibility, honesty, capacity. Right from my childhood I know her. If anybody says that she is dishonest, am I going to accept? No. Even if Swami comes and says, Mr. Anil Kumar, this, I am not going to accept. God comes next to mother. Therefore, my friends, is not Baba your mother? Is that Baba your father? If anyone speaks something nonsense, are you going to believe that? Are you going to accept? Or are you going to blame your parents? Are you going to bring a bad name to them? No. So this is my next objective. And another objective is to help to think in a new direction. After Swami left, our presentation should be different. Our outlook should be different. Our leadership should be different. Our approach should be different. Till now, Swami has been the center of attraction. Hereafter, people see Swami in you. They have seen him only till now. Hereafter, they will see him in all of us, individually and collectively. And therefore, it's a greater responsibility. We have got to be more loving. We have got to be more accountable. We have got to be more credible. We are answerable. Otherwise, we'll be simply a bull. Should I be a bull or answerable? Should I be a bull or accountable? That's the question in front of him. Therefore, my friends, my travels, my talks to people at different places are towards this particular objective. And to make the second line of leadership ready to take up the organization. There is one change, one thing, a difference between Swami organization and other organizations. Christian organizations have full-time missionaries to carry the torch of Christian mission. Ramakrishna Mission has Swamijis to carry the mission full-time. Satsai Mission has all of us householders. We don't have full-time missionaries, fathers, nuns, Swamijis. Does not Swami know this? He knows. Can't he think of the future? He did. Then why did he choose householders as his missionaries? When I speak to you, you love to listen to me because I am a family man with 4 children. I have gone through the crucible of life. I have gone through the furnace of life. Therefore, my words have got more of authenticity. He has chosen householders because one householder knows the problems of another householder. One knows the other person much better than man on the other side of life. We are not celibates, brahmacharis. We are not renunciants, sannyasis. We are householders. Bhagavan, what is the solution for all of us? Family or you? Children or you? Job or you? What shall I do? Do you know what Baba said, my friends? Who said it is your family? Who said they are your children? Who said that it is your job? It is my job to take care of your family, your life and yours. It is not yours. Swami, shall I believe you? Yes. Simple example. While traveling in a train, do you carry the luggage on your head? Do you? No. You put down your luggage on the floor, sit in the compartment, neatly go. Who bears the weight? You bear the weight? No. The train bears the weight. The train is such as an intercontinental, intergalactical airline that will carry the baggage, lifetime baggage, any number of pieces, weight is no bar. Not one piece, half piece, 22 kgs, 20, no. Come on, put the load, 1000 of kgs or 100 bags ready. Because it's intergalactical, intercontinental, such as an airline. So, never feel that your family is coming in the way, that your job is coming in the way, because it's not your family. It's not your job. It's my job. And it's not Baba's assurance now. He assured in the previous life also, assured in Shirdi, leave your burdens on my shoulders. I'll carry on with pleasure. Satsai Baba says, leave your burdens at my feet. Go back with loads and loads of joy, bliss and pleasure. If we have faith in that, we have nothing to regret. No reason to cry. No reason to worry about. No reason to be anxious about any visit, about any eventual situation to happen. We all have problems. The difference between Sai devotee and the rest of the world is this. In the rest of the world, every devotee is down, frustrated, depressed, totally, mentally gone, physically gone, because of a problem. A Sai devotee is still able to survive. Still able to smile, still able to accept, still able to reconcile. With smile, what is greatest miracle of Baba? People may say, he gave me the ring, that is a miracle. Nonsense. There are many rings available in the jewelry shop. He saved me from death. Okay, that doesn't mean you are going to be immortal. apple. The date of expiry is still to be awaited. So there is not that. The greatest miracle is, my friends, I'm so happy to see you listening to me in rapt attention. The greatest miracle is the gift of spirit of acceptance that Baba has given. The spirit of acceptance. He is there with both the hands lifted. For information, she is my wife, Vijayalakshmi Kamaraju. Well, I should introduce her because she has been bearing with me for the last several years, which is really a torture indeed. This being India, there is no way out. Therefore, my friends, greatest gift of Baba is the spirit of acceptance. We accept, come what may, pleasure or pain, pleasure or pain. We are ready. He has given us that spirit of acceptance. We know how to be humble. Such a Sai is global. Such a Sai is cosmic. So we should have that cosmic love. We should have that global harmony. We should have that international fraternity. Then only we deserve to be called Baba devotees. Not till then. Not till then. If we have not cultivated that global fraternity, cosmic relationship, international spirit of love, I can only say we have a long way to go. But I am so happy to see devotees from Qatar and Doha. And sir, when you go back to Dallas, you go back? You'll see me there in July. You can't avoid me in US because my two daughters are there. And I don't stay them there either. I don't stay with them. My children, when they are here with me, they always had one complaint because I never stayed at home, going around Sai organizations, Sai activity. Even now they complain because I don't stay with them there abroad. I go on moving. But the life is designed what to do. Ultimately they reconcile that daddy is for all, not for the family alone. Better late than never. So, sir, the life is something like that. Baba himself commented. I don't go into the details. I'll cut the story short. Cut the story short. A simple thing. Swami said in Varanda. Varanda is a place where we feel inconvenient. You may feel you are a VIP because you are sitting in Varanda and all that. But if Swami remarks anything negative, you'll feel so bad, insulted. But Swami chooses that place only. Rings, watches he will give in the interview room. Scolding you in public. That is the divine art. He scolds you heavy dose in public. Swami, why do you do that? You can call me in the interview room and beat me. I can tell outside I got interview. Why do you do that in the veranda, cold like that? Baba said, to make you free from ego. When once ego goes, you are 100% spiritual. So this kind of frying, keeping in furnace, hot climate, living in hot oven, is only to make us free from ego. Bhagwan is not vindictive. Bhagwan is never revengeful. He wants us to be free from ego. Yes. And we get repeated treatments. Gold, until it is polished, it should be hammered and put in fire. Natural. It knows the pain and heat. Not we don't know. because we wear it as a jewel, but the poor gold knows whatever it is. Whenever people come and say, Anil Kumar, you are very fortunate, da 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 da, please ask the gold how much of a problem it has. But that gold has got an end for the polishing. But human life polishing continues, life after life. We have come to this state after years, lives of culturing, lives of refinement, lives of processing by the divine goldsmith, Bhagavan Sri Satsang Baba. So all right, we are happy about it. Coming back to the point, in the veranda before everybody he said, before everybody, this fellow, looking at me, I was the state president of Andhra Pradesh. This fellow always carries a suitcase with him, goes around the state of Andhra Pradesh, talking, 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 leaving the whole responsibility of his family on my head. I have to carry on the responsibility of the whole thing. His careless number, he goes on and gave me a smile. Okay. When he came to me closely, I slightly whispered. What did I say? Swami, you are carrying my responsibility much better than what I would have done myself. And what I have done, you are doing better than what I have done. This is really surprising. In the, every one of your life, you are the witness, not Anil Kumar, you are the witness how Swami's hand helped you, how Swami's hand protected you, how Swami's hand stood as a support to you and your children. That day I fondly remember. I also know how Swami loves everybody. I'll give one instance because I don't know what you expect from me. But Anil Kumar is a non-stop communicator. With that limitation, I say another simple experience. He was distributing chocolates to everybody. I didn't feel like eating them. Cadbury's chocolates, Choco bars, like that. After a couple of days he said, when all are eating, one fellow is not eating. Search their bags, as if we are getting through customs section. Then I said, Swami, don't take too much of trouble. I am not eating. Then Baba said, why are you not eating? I am not eating because I have 4 children, 3 daughters and a son. When I take back these chocolates and peppermints, they'll jump in joy from Swami, Swami. They'll be so happy that these are gifts from Swami. Then Baba said, you feel happy when your children eat. Please understand, I feel equally happy when you eat in front of me. So since that day, he started giving me everything in 5s, 4 for children, 1 for immediate consumption there, all eatables. So nice that God takes care of all of us. God loves us. Please take these experiences as general experiences. Because I am holding the mic, I am talking to you, I am telling these experiences. If you are given this experience, this mic, you will speak your experiences. And your experiences are not different from my experiences. No. Sea water is saline, full of salt, either Pacific or Bay of Bengal or Hindu Ocean or Atlantic. So a devotee from Doha or Qatar is as great, as powerful, as equal, as majestic, as divine as Anil Kumar, and they are even more than Anil Kumar. They are more, because staying there far off place like Qatar and all that, if not from distance, at least from cultural bonds, at least from religious strings, you are staying there. And still you could become Baba's devotees. I can give you 100% guarantee. Guarantee, yes. If you want, I can sign on bond paper also. You would not have been here. You could not have been his devotees while staying in Doha and Qatar. Unless, until he willed you, decided you to draw all of you close to his lotus feet. Out of his pure love for you. Out of his pure love for you. How do you say that? All are not drawn here. Is it the only population in Qatar? There are many. All are not here. Why are you here? You are chosen. You are chosen. We are not elected. We are not selected. We are chosen. Selection be on the consideration of status, dignity, education. Election on grounds of popularity. Chosen on spiritual background. You are chosen as a result of mercy, compassion, the divine will of Bhagavan, but not at the human instance. I'm thoroughly convinced, my friends, particularly when I meet devotees coming from far off places like this. How do you explain devotees from Argentina, devotees from Peru, far off place, who never saw Swami, but to my experience I can say they are greater devotees than many of us here. They are greater devotees. They speak Spanish. They don't speak Indian language. They are at a far off place. They cannot afford to come here every time. Where is Peru? Where is Argentina? Where is Gautamala? Is it easy to come here? No. All people can't afford. But in devotion I can say, in front of Swami, they are 1,000 times more than many people I know. Why? Selection, no. Election, certainly not. Chosen, they are the chosen children of such a Sai Baba. You are the chosen children of such Sai Baba. We are the chosen children of such Sai Baba. Let us be conscious of it. Let us be aware of it. Let us be grateful to him. Let us be thankful to him. Let us also see how best to live up to his expectations in standards. Above all, let us determine to spread his mission, which is very important. I tell all my old students here, they say, Swami showed his love. I was here in Swami's college. Very good. What are you doing now? Yes. I was born to my parents. I was brought up by my parents. Good. What am I doing to them? Likewise, Baba, you studied in Swami's institution. You are the students of Swami's college. Now what are you doing? That's my question. Are you participating in service activities? Are you spreading his message? Have you influenced one colleague of yours in the office? Or else, it's not a credit to say that I am Sai's student. Of course, there are many people who are doing good service. There are many who are living up to his standards. But Swami's standard is, expectation is very, very high. 100%. If you get 85, he won't praise you. How about that 15 marks? If fellow says, Swami, I got 70, a useless fellow. 70 is the passing mark in Swami's college, you know that? Therefore, Swami's standards are very high. Let us be 100% qualified devotees of Baba with credibility, accountability, answerability. so that our dear God will feel proud of us. I buy this pen, it's 20 rupees for example. If somebody says not even worth 5 rupees, I purchased with 25 rupees, you say it is not even worth 5 rupees, what shall I do? I feel so bad for having wasted my money. Baba has all of us as a matter of divine investment, divine corpus fund, divine capital. He should get interest out of it. What interest? Seva, service is the interest that we pay. Faith, compound interest we pay. Therefore, my friends, with this note, I really want to know from you what you really expect from me, what doubts you have, so that I serve you what you want. Yes. We need love. How do you get love? We need love. How do we get love? I really appreciate that question, because love is God. God is love. Live in love. Therefore, your question is completely spiritual. I appreciate you. You are from? South Africa. Oh, many from South Africa have been visiting this place since long, and they have sufficient background of Sai literature. I appreciate you. Okay, we need love. How to develop love? I quote what Swami said. If not in verbatim, the summary of it I would share with you. Child loves the mother. Who taught her how to love? Does the child realize the need of love? As the days pass on, the boy loves his friends. Who taught him love? As he ages further and further, well, he loves the opposite gender. Who taught him that? Later he has got his own family, responsibility and commitments. What made him love like that? He loves life more than anything else. Because it was Alexander the Great who said that he will give whole of his kingdom if his life to be extended by 5 minutes. If his life is to be extended by 5 minutes, he is ready to give his kingdom. Impossible, sir. Time to leave. So similarly, who taught us love? Love. We are born with love. We are born with love. It is the love that makes us live together. I love my life. So it is my love of my life made me to continue to live. If I don't love my life, well, I don't have any taste of life. There's no chance of continuing to live. I can end my life. Why don't I end my life? Because I love my life. I love my body. Every one of us, if we stand in front of the mirror, everyone thinks that he is a film star. Hollywood, Jollywood, Bollywood and that. Tollywood. Though the friend says, you are not my dear friend. You are not that handsome as you think. Shut up. You don't know how handsome I am. So everyone loves his own body. If everyone says, you look good, is that so? Adjust the hair immediately. I love my mind. Why? Because I think I am quite intelligent. I think I have a sharp memory. If anyone says you are a forgetful man, I feel so bad. I feel so bad. Mr. Guan, have you forgotten me? Oh, I think we lost your memory. It's a damaging statement. I love my mind. I don't want anybody to question my memory. I love my intellect. Is it your good decision to come to Puttaparthi? Yes. No nonsense. Maybe. But my intellect has taken correct decision. So I love my body, I love my mind, I love my intellect, I will love my life. And this love is the one with which I am born with, as gift of God. The need for love is selfish. Need is artificial. Need is unnatural. I want to go to Doha. Sir, how to come to you? I love you very much. Artificial. I love my boss until he retires. Or until I get a promotion. I love my wife until she obliges me. When she says no, sir, then comes the problem. So the need for love is commercial. The need for love is unnatural. The need for love is artificial. Need for love is demanding. The natural love is not commanding, is not demanding. You are born with love. It goes on increasing. It goes on expanding. That love is God. And that God is love. Live in love. Thank you. Good, good. That's why you are there in Qatar, Doha and South Africa. Good.
Madam sir, in one of the study circles in Bahrain, yeah, I am Dr. Babu from Doha, Qatar. Not MBA doctor, PhD.
What if you are a doctor?
Madam sir, see, one of the study circles we had, I attended one study circle in Bahrain, as well as in Qatar. There was one question which was asked, so much cash was found in Swami's room. Why that happened? Okay, something, it should have been deposited in the bank, why it was kept in the room? That was the reason many people asked, which we have some answers, but I would like to hear from you.
Oh, I see. My dear friend, I appreciate your frankness. I appreciate your openness. I appreciate your guts to ask that question. All have questions they don't ask. But I appreciate you. It's a Muslim country, right? Muslims are known for guts. That environment must have made you so courageous. Had you been rural, you won't have been like that. But my answer, my friend, out of my experience, personal knowledge, which differs. Personal experiences, observations differ from person to person. General observation, general experiences are acceptable. Oxygen, we breathe oxygen. General, correct. I don't breathe oxygen, personal. So I give you my personal observation with the long association. People in darshan line, they try to give cash to Swami, put currency in sealed covers and pass it on. Our good Swami knows what it is. There are thousand instances when I saw Swami throwing back the covers. You too must have seen. He refuses to access from envelopes. You must have noticed, everybody. Most of them are checks, drafts and money. Refuse. Two, there are many of the checks, drafts which are not encashed. Supposing I got a draft with me, dated 2000. What does it mean? Do you accept it? No. After 6 months, check is invalid, right? Therefore, if there is a draft and a check which is not encashed, lying there, what does it mean? I don't encash, I am not connected with that, I am not interested in that money. Right? That is the second point. The third point, we devotees, we all of us, this includes me, maybe the first to begin with. When Swami does not take, what do? We send it by courier. You cannot refuse now. Why? I had been to Japan long ago, say 92 or so, and I brought some lovely dolls from Japan. The Japan people, sayonara, sayonara style, the Japanese dress and all that. Looks nice dolls, nice sprays I brought from Japan of this size. And I sent into the interview room. After bhajan, it is a return. And Swami sends me a word, gives to his children these dolls and toys and sprays better. And I am not angry with him. Let him share with his family. What do I do with these things? He told me he politely refused. Instead of saying, I don't want, he said in a Western style, better you give it to your children. I don't want is the Eastern style. Keep it to yourself is the Western style. Polite way of refusing. But my ego did not accept it. I couriered the whole parcel into me. By courier. What was the reaction? He did not talk to me for a couple of months without telling the reason. But I know the reason, no one else. It's good that he did not stay on the stage to save my prestige. But what happened? I sent by courier. Like that, devotees send checks and drafts and cash, they courier them to Swami. And they just lie down on the ground, which are not encashed. Therefore, this is a proof to say that Swami is not for money. Swami is not for money. He refuses when he goes on along the darshan lines. Checks and cash lying over there have not been deposited. Just neglected that. He is not bothered about it. And thirdly, it was a time of conference of sadhus. You know a sadhu? Sadhu is a sannyasi, brahmachari. Sadhus from Andhra Pradesh had a conference here. Swami gave them some lakhs for their maintenance, to have a van and to propagate Hindu mission. They spent money and came with accounts. I was standing by side of money, by Swami. They were with all accounts and balance. Swami said, close it. I am not here to see the balance. No. Make use of money. Ask me more if you want. Not that balance, budget. I got the world budget, international budget, not only this. Take it back, he said. He is not interested in money. And another instance, a miracle. There is one of our students who is working in Central Rice Research Institute there at Mysore. My own student is working there now with PhD. He was my student in the institute. It was Deepavali time. During Deepavali, you know Deepavali? Diwali, okay. People go to their native places. But some students prefer to stay with Swami. This boy stayed with Swami without going home. Suddenly Swami looked at him and said, boy, Papa, what a pity it is. There are so many covers. Swami takes letters from devotees. You pick up any letter, whatever that is there in the letter, you take it. Even if it is a scorpion or a snake. Swami, Swami, don't worry, I am here. That won't come on, take him. That fellow took one cover, just random. Swami said, open it. He opened. 500 rupee note is there. And Swami said, I was there. This. And Swami said, Arey boy, you are not going to the canteen for breakfast and lunch. You don't have money. Swami students don't borrow. They don't steal. You wrote one letter to your father to send you 500 rupees. It takes time for him to reach the letter, to receive and send you. So I am giving you 500, take it. Had you asked for 5,000, I would have given you 5,000. You asked only for 500, it is your mistake, come on it. That is Bhagavan Baba, sir, is not attached. Okay? Thank you for your question. Thank you.
Be always happy, happy, happy.